Plus, she was devastated after having cancer and told she couldn't have children. Now, thanks to her sister, her dream may become a reality. The breakthrough surgery done right here in St. Louis. Well, a St. Louis doctor who pioneered a breakthrough surgery for women who couldn't have children.
Yeah, up next, the new surgery that could help millions more in the joy he's bringing to one woman right now.
Well, it was once said sisters probably have the most competitive relationship within a family, but once they've grown, it becomes the strongest relationship. Two San Francisco sisters who flew to St. Louis this week have proven that theory. They came here for a breakthrough medical procedure that should provide hope for millions of women who are trying to have a baby.
It was tough because I wanted to have kids.
Tough doesn't even explain it, but Joy Lagos is a survivor.
3 years ago, I was diagnosed with stage 4 peripheral T-cell lymphoma, which is a non-Hodgkin's lymphoma.
After a bone marrow transplant from her sister and extensive chemotherapy, she found out she couldn't have children.
I just want to be a mom.
Joy has this thing where she's the emotional one and I'm not so much, so I just go into, you know,
fix-it mode.
Fix-it mode.
So after turning to her sister for bone marrow, she was turning to her sister again, this time for an ovary.
I didn't even feel like I had to ask. I just knew she would give me anything.
And she just called and said, we found a guy.
That guy was Dr. Sherman Silber at St. Luke's Hospital in Chesterfield. He's now performed several ovarian transplants, the first making news around the world when two Alabama sisters came to St. Louis. Less than 3 years later, the sisters who couldn't have a baby now have two. But this week's surgery was a first of its kind with two non-identical sisters.
Every time you do it, it's the same kind of emotional rush because it seems like it's just impossible to do.
Impossible because it's so delicate. In fact, even Dr. Silber, who's performed hundreds of transplants, was in awe.
You know, when you're walking on the edge of a cliff like the Grand Canyon, you're not supposed to look down because you get dizzy and it kind of scares you. Same way, I looked away from the microscope just to see what we were really suturing, and it was scary because it just looks like it's going to tear apart.
But after another successful transplant, Dr. Silber says this will offer hope to millions of other women trying to conceive.
So this is just the beginning of being able to extend ovary transplantation to non-identical sisters.
And just 2 days after the surgery, Joy was celebrating her 30th birthday with big dreams for the future.
I'd like to start with two. My husband wants three. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. I'll just be grateful to have one.
This week's surgery is the culmination of more than 30 years of research by Dr. Silber. If this story wasn't amazing enough itself, the sister who gave her ovary to her flew back home just 2 days after the surgery. Joy will spend less than a week in the hospital. Just amazing. It's, you know, it's such great news for
her. You feel happy for
her. Oh, yeah.
You know, with her smile. She's
and for
crying.
So many women who can't have children,
he is amazing,
this breakthrough
isn't he?
Surgery mm-hmm. is phenomenal. Yeah.